Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Mike, and in Halo, plasma weapons are used by the alien force called the Covenant and come in both handheld, stationary, and shoulder-mounted variants, with devastating effects on both soft targets and shields alike. But what if plasma weapons were real? Plasma usually is only present in very low pressure, such as fluorescent light bulbs, and in very high pressure, such as the sun. Plasma is an ionized gas, constituting of positive ions and free-flowing electrons. Because of its intrinsic properties, harnessing plasma for military applications would be very difficult. The Covenant have a couple different plasma weapons. First, let's look at the projectile class. This includes plasma rifles, plasma pistols, and plasma turrets. The problem with plasma is the low density and mass. Due to air resistance, the plasma shot would expand, increasing the surface area and cooling off. When plasma cools, the electrons are pulled back to the nucleus and the plasma transforms back into a gas state. The plasma would essentially be a glorified air launcher. In the game, the plasma pistol doesn't shoot very fast at all, and assuming that this somehow negated the heat transfer issues and the expansion issues, which it doesn't, at that speed the plasma pistol wouldn't really shoot very far at all. From a high-level review, it's pretty evident that the rifle ammunition tanks would be bulky, the magnetic gas energizer would be expensive, and the performance would be, well, underwhelming to say the least. This might be why the Covenant developed such weapons as the Carbine and the Needler. Solid projectiles are not only easier to produce, but they perform better in environments with atmospheres and gravity. Moving to another Covenant weapon using plasma technology is none other than the plasma grenade. The plasma grenade is an interesting idea because it utilizes plasma technology at all of its strengths. A solid outer shell holding the high pressure inside. With a magnetic field or heat generation from force chemical reaction inside, the grenade would generate large pressures, ultimately causing it to explode and spraying magnetically charged plasma to the surrounding areas. The outside of the grenade would get very, very hot, causing the outside paint and materials to catch on fire and glow. On impact with flesh or composite armor, it would be hot enough to melt and potentially stick to the recipient. With temperatures ranging from a few hundred degrees to a few thousand degrees, you wouldn't want a plasma pistol to go off anywhere near you. Its devastation continues as combustible materials nearby would burst into flames. If one of these went off in a residential area or near an ammunition dump, the effects would be devastating. Although plasma weapons do lack some of the properties that define an effective weapon system, when harnessed in the proper fashion, they can be quite devastating. One attribute of plasma weapons that wasn't quite explored were the magnetic properties of plasma. It's likely that plasma weapons' effectiveness on energy-based shields is attributed to its magnetic charge, leaving room for some really interesting research on energy shields. But that was just a quick look at plasma weapons and if they can actually exist. If you want to see more on Halo and the science of Halo, be sure to check out the videos on screen and subscribe for more. Let me know in the comments down below, what is a technology in video games that you find interesting and you want to know more about? Anyways, guys, as always, thanks for watching.